हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी। नाउ लुक एट दिस एग्जांपल। हेयर हिस्टोग्राम इज गिवन एंड वी हैव टू गिव सम क्वेश्चंस। नाउ इन फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इंफॉर्मेशन इज डिपिक्टेड बाय द बिलो हिस्टोग्राम। व्हेन वी सी दिस हिस्टोग्राम, ऑन एक्स एक्सिस वी हैव गिवन सैलरीज इन रुपीज, ऑन वाई एक्सिस वी हैव गिवन नंबर ऑफ वर्कर्स। So, the histogram depicts the salaries obtained by workers. Now, in second question, prepare a grouped frequency table for the histogram. Here, class interval 2000 to 2500, the bar is raised up to 50. So, the frequency is 50 for the interval 2000 to 2500. And for next interval 2500 to 3000, frequencies are 40. And the next interval 3000 to 3500, frequencies are given 80. And in next interval 3500 to 4000, frequencies are 60. And in next interval 4000 to 4500, frequencies are given 20. And in next interval 4500 to 5000, frequencies are 10. Now, the total number of worker, when we see this number of workers, we add all the number of workers, these are 260. Now, in next question, find the number of workers having salaries more than rupees 3500. So when we see this histogram, we can see here the interval 3500 to 4000, here the number of workers are 60, and between 4000 to 4500 number of workers are 20, and between 4500 to 5000 number of workers are 10. So we have to add all these three frequencies, 60 plus 20 plus 10, and these are equals to 90. So 90 workers are there, they have their salaries more than rupees 3500. Now in next question, in which group is the number of workers maximum? So when we see this histogram, we can see here the highest bar having frequencies 80, and its class interval is 3000 to 3500. So number of workers are maximum in this class interval 3000 to 3500. Now in next question, in which group is the number of workers minimum? So when we see this histogram, we can see here the minimum frequency of the bar having class interval 4500 to 5000. So this is a class interval in which the number of workers are minimum. Now, what are the class marks of class interval having maximum frequency? So here, the maximum frequency of the class interval, that is 3000 to 3500. So we have to calculate its class mark, that is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So it is 3000 plus 3500 divided by 2, it is 6500 divided by 2, and it is equals to 3250. Now look at this question. The water bills and rupees of 30 houses are given. Construct a grouped frequency table with class size 15. So here in the given data, we have to look for the minimum value. So we can see here the minimum value is 14 here, and the maximum value of this given data, that is 112. So maximum value is 112 and minimum value is 14 here. Now we have to construct a class interval here, and in this question we have given the class size is 15. So here we have to make the classes in such a way that first class includes the minimum value and last class includes the maximum value. So we have to take first interval, that is 0 to 15. Here class size is 15, and in this interval we have to include the value which is greater 0 or greater than 0, but it is smaller than 15, because in this interval we have to take the value which lies in this range between 0 to 15. Here upper limit, that is 15, will not be included, but lower limit and the value which varies between lower to upper limit, that will be included here. So here the frequency is 2. And now in next class interval, the upper limit of first class interval will be the lower limit of next class interval. So next class interval will be 15 to 30. Here lower limit is 15 and upper limit is 30. So here we have to take the values which are 15 and greater than 15 but smaller than 30. So its frequencies are 2. Similarly, we have to repeat this pattern. We have to repeat this pattern that lower limit will be included and the values lies between lower and upper, that will be included in that particular interval, but upper limit will not be included, and upper limit will be the lower limit of next class interval. So this is the required frequency distribution table. And now in next question, here the given pie chart, which is given, represents the amount spent on different sports by a school in a year. If the total money spent on football is rupees 5000, then we have to give some answers. And first look at this pie chart. Here the sector of hockey, its central angle is given 100 degree. The sector which is showing cricket, its central angle is 160 degree. The sector for tennis, its central angle is 10 degree. And next, here the sector is showing football, its central angle is 50 degree. Next sector is for basketball, its central angle is 40 degree. Now we have to give some questions. In first question, what is the amount spent on sports? So here money spent on football, that is given in the question, it is rupees 5000. Now we have to let money spent on sports, it is x. Now here we have to put central angle of the corresponding sector, that is for football it is given here 50 degree, and it is divided by 360 degree and multiply by total amount spent on sports, that we let here x, and this is equals to the amount spent on football, that is 5000. On solving this, here we are getting the value of x, that is rupees 36000. Now in second part, how much money is spent on hockey? Here let money spent on hockey is equals to y. So here y, that is the money spent on hockey, is equals to the central angle of the corresponding sector. Here for hockey it is given 100 degree divided by 360 degree and multiply by total amount spent on sports, that is we calculated in previous part 36000. On solving this, we are getting here the value of y is rupees 10000. Now in third part, how much more money is spent on cricket than hockey? So here first we have to calculate the money spent on cricket. We let it here z, and z is equals to central angle of the corresponding sector. Here it is given for cricket, that is 160 degree divided by 360 degree, multiply by total amount spent on sports, that is 36000. On solving this, here we are getting rupees 16000. Now we have to calculate here more money spent in cricket than hockey. So 16000 minus 10000 is equals to rupees 6000, and this is the amount which is spent more on cricket than hockey. Now, in this example, the numbers were written in separate slips. On picking a slip, 1, 15, 9, 7, 48, 18, 6, 36, 73, 4, what is the probability of getting an even number, a multiple of 3, a one digit number, a multiple of 3 but not 9? Now in first part, probability of an event is equals to number of favorite outcomes divided by total number of possible outcomes. Here even numbers are 18, 48, 6, 36 and 4, and number of outcomes is equals to 5. So probability of an getting even number is equals to 5 upon 10 and its value is equals to 1 upon 2. Now in second part, a multiple of 3 is equals to 15, 9, 48, 18, 6 and 36. So number of outcomes is 6 and probability of a multiple of 3 is equals to 6 upon 10 and its lowest term is 3 upon 5. Now one digit number 1, 9, 7, 6 and 4. So number of outcomes 5 and probability of one digit number is equals to 5 upon 10 and its lowest value is 1 upon 2. Now in next part, a multiple of 3 but not 9 are 15, 48, 6, number of outcomes 3 and probability of a multiple of 3 but not 9 is equals to 3 upon 10. Now home assignments, do brain teaser from question 2 to 8 of chapter 15. Thank you.